Let's take a cube and dissect it. We will keep this one as the reference. Take another cube exactly like this one and dissect it. By dissect, I mean that we will open the cube up along its edges. And what will we get if we open it up? Let's see. We can open the top face first. This looks like a box with its top face open. Then we can open the green face in the front. Then we drop the orange and the blue faces on the right. The faces that remain are the face to the left and the face behind. Next, we can drop the left face to the left, and then we drop the only remaining face behind. Now we have completely opened up the cube along its edges to get a two-dimensional shape like this. But what is this? What is it called? This is called the net of the solid. In this case, it's the net of a cube. A net is a diagram which shows what the solid will look like when it is opened along its edges and laid flat. The net, as we can see, is clearly two-dimensional. If we look at it from the top, it will look like this. The orange face is the face to the right, the blue face is the top face, the green face is the face in the front, the black face is the base, the purple one was on the one at the back, and the red one was on the left. Yes, all we did was open up the faces along the edges and we got the net of a solid. Now listen to the next question carefully. Does the net of this solid have to look exactly like this? Is this the only possible net of the cube? Maybe not. Let's see if we can open up the same cube differently. We open up the top face first along this edge. Then we open up the front face outwards towards the right. Then we make the side face fall towards the right. There are still two faces remaining, the purple one at the back and the red one to the left. So we drop the left face towards the left and the back face backwards. This is what we get. It's clearly different from the earlier one. To know how it's different, let's look at the top view. The top view will look like this. So drawing the net of a solid may result in different figures. It doesn't have to be the same. I'm sure you have understood the concept of a net by now. It's easy for me to draw the net of a three-dimensional shape using software, but how would you draw the net of a solid in your notebook? Well, you would have to pull out the architect in you. Look at this cube. How would you draw the net of this cube in your notebook? You don't have 3D software, so you need to imagine. One good way to draw a net would be by naming the faces. We can call the face in the front F and the face at the back B. The face which is down can be called D and the one at the top can be called T. And L and R for left and right. These are the six faces. F, B, T, D, L and R. Now when we draw the net of this cube, we should make sure that all faces are covered. We should start off by having one face as the reference. Let's move this to the left. D would be a good face to start off with. We draw the base D here. Now we need to imagine as if we are opening up the figure. We can drop R and T together towards the right. Yes, we can drop the face on the right and the face on the top. R would be here and T would be here next to R. We have covered three faces. And all the three remaining faces are attached to the three remaining edges of D. The face in the front when dropped will look like this. The face on the left when dropped towards the left will look like this. And the back face will be attached to the top edge of D. This is one of the ways in which the net of this cube can be drawn. One way to verify it is by making sure that all the faces of the three-dimensional shape are covered. In the next session, we will look at nets of a few more figures.